The Basel III Endgame proposal undoubtedly was, you know, well-intentioned by the regulators, but unfortunately, it doesn't meet the targets that they set out in terms of what it's supposed to do, and actually creates other problems. First, it was meant to mesh the global standards so that the U.S. banks were on a level playing field with everybody else, and everybody's playing by the same rules. In fact, it doesn't do that. It really layers on top of the U.S. rules additional capital requirements, making the U.S. banks less competitive than the foreign banks. But, you know, even more, as articulated by the regulators, it was meant to deal with the SVB runs on the bank problem of the spring of 2023 or late winter. It doesn't do that at all. The amount of capital that it's proposing to layer on top, and it's a lot of extra capital, would have done nothing to stop those runs at all. So it wouldn't have addressed the problem in any serious way, in any way, really. So it fails in terms of both its goals, and it puts U.S. banks actually at a competitive advantage. Furthermore, it doesn't really address, it takes up our time, things that actually don't address the really serious safety and soundness problems that U.S. banks are facing as we get into the 21st century. By making the operation of banks more expensive, and that's what capital does, you keep layering it on, and it's an expense. Yes, it can be a cushion, but it's an expense. It makes certain activities non-competitive and or impossible for the banks really to do. And one of the areas that it really makes the banks both non-competitive and unable to fulfill their function is in the trading area and the derivatives area. In fact, it isn't just the banks that have been complaining about the impact of the endgame rule on these activities, but it's the private sector, because the failure of the banks to offer a number of these important derivatives activities really hurts the private sector, hurts our business component of the economy as much as it does the banks. So that's really a big danger. Well, I'm afraid, as you can tell, I'm not a fan of the proposal. And I think the proposal as proposed ought to be withdrawn. We've got a lot of safety and soundness issues that are important to America, important to America's banks. It should be addressed. Tail risk. Why did we have these runs? How does the internet and misuse of the internet impact banking? You know, that seems to be first chair. But if we're going to back to try to harmonize the rules and indeed deal with any rule of this magnitude, what we shouldn't have is confrontation where rules are just presented anymore. A modern way to deal with rules is actually collaboration. So what I would say is if we're going to get into this area, what we ought to start out with is a collaborative approach among industry, safety and soundness regulators, maybe capital markets players, to sit and discuss with the rule, the aspects of the rule, how it's going to better safety and soundness, and how it's going to fit into the entire fabric of our regulatory framework before we do anything. This is one where I think we do not shoot first and ask questions later. This is where we ask questions first and shoot later. I think that approach ought to be applied to a serious rule that we're dealing with in America, but certainly this set of rules.